have asked about my status in the comments and shipped JC and I. I love JC. He is my work husband. Why am I doing this with my hair? But we are not dating. As I've said, he's single. Reach out to him. And I am also dating someone else. So I can't date JC.
Tepid applause. Golf clap. We're in Scotland. I think golf was invented there. I don't know for sure. I feel like I've heard someone I hang out with a lot mention that. Whatever.
Let's see. There's two pilots.
Meaning men who are pilots,
they fly pilots
of television
shows.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. So don't think industry. Yeah. I think we've become cool again and relevant, but maybe we're just too old. No one likes the old people.
That's not true.
We're just old.
Very young demographic.
We smell like mothballs. Why do you think? You're into this thing.
I think that the Oscars treat superhero movies in the same way that Emmys treat great reality television. I want Emmy noms for The Bachelor and Housewives, and that's how I feel about it.
So what Zima's saying is, I am Iron Man.
We're walking through an airport. We're stopping at the gift shop. All we see is the covers. We're late for our flight. We've got to catch it. We should have left earlier. Luckily, we only had a carry-on and we have TSA pre-check. This is how I operate. I get to the airport very late. Certain people in my life who are very important to me are much more prompt than myself. Who do you think I'm talking about?
Perhaps my favorite behind-the-scenes photo revealed was Hannah and Chris Harrison on night one, and I just want to say, wow. Not wow like what you're thinking. I mean, everybody looks good. But Hannah, so the editing gets a little weird from here. Now Chris and Hannah are talking on these blue chairs. We don't really know where.
But I will say that the blue chairs really brought out Chris Harrison's blue eyes, didn't they? Just get lost in them. I need to because I'm so stressed out by this episode. Anyway.
Oh, we're babies.
Oh. That was like
so much has changed.
2 years ago. Yeah, speaking of which, Lauren.
Tea.
Also, is got closer to the franchise.
In what way?
She is now the...
look at her face.
The lady friend, girlfriend of one Chris Harrison.
Woo! That's what we say. We say lady friend.
Lady friend?
A lady friend.
I just want to know who slid into whose DM.
Oh, I DM'd him.
You did? See?
Yeah.
She did DM him.
Oh! Yeah.
Said uh-oh.
Something about... he mentioned something about like picking his kids up or something. He somehow brought up like being single, I think. And then I said,
okay. There we go.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm.
If only I had someone to pick up my kids with.
No. I said something like, I'm single now. And he was like, oh, but I said it in a more eloquent way than that. I don't know. Somehow
it two people
somehow
being like,
was communicated. Like the other day, somebody asked us how we met, and I waited to hear him tell the story for the first time. And it made me really happy. He told it exactly the same way. And he used the same phrase that I've used when telling my friends, which is we had our first human conversation. So after that conversation, I wasn't sure if I'd totally read it right. So I wouldn't have asked him out if he hadn't reciprocated.
Or just waterfall. Be very romantic.
He is.
He's a guy's guy.
He is a guy's guy, but he's also, I mean, I sort of feel that I'm reaping the benefits of someone who's worked on this show and learned how to talk to women for so long. He is so communicative. He's so thoughtful. He's so clear with his feelings and a good listener. I mean, you know, date an interviewer. We listen. It's great. I don't expect bachelor dates from him, but I will tell you, he's taken me on a helicopter.
Oh, yes.
Okay. I really got to tell you, I'm going to get so sappy, but I could have fun with him anywhere. I have such a great time with him. I have so much fun with him, and I'm so happy with him if we're like scanning through movies to find something to watch on TV or if we were in the helicopter.
Aww. That's great.
Yeah.
As we drop into a quiet little place and have a drink or two. And then I go and spoil it all by saying something stupid like I love you.
Also, I want to give a shout out to one more good man. You may notice that we have some beautiful real roses here on the Roses and Rosé set today. These are the most gorgeous flowers I have ever received in my life, and they were sent to me by one Chris Harrison. Thank you, Chris Harrison. It was for the anniversary of our first conversation. I know. This is gonna be tough, so we might need to take some nice breaks for positivity. Let's take a break for positivity and drink for every beautiful flower.
You've had more chances than anyone here, dude.
And then Chris Harrison. And then, what a man, what a mighty good man, Chris Harrison asks Hannah what she wants to choose.
What do you want? This is all up to you.
Tyler and Chris both asking Hannah for her decision instead of telling her what it is. Then Luke says to Chris Harrison, quote, I'm trying to think of how to put this so it's clear to you.
Trying to think of how to put this so it's clear to you.
Yeah.
Trust me, babe, he's good. And then Luke just told Chris Harrison to think about what he was asking.
Think about what you're asking.
And Luke, I stood up out of my chair, just like Tyler stood up for Hannah. But you know what? Just like Tyler, I'm gonna step back because Chris Harrison has got this and he is not fazed. And drink for Chris Harrison's adorable laugh during all that.
Oh, God! You guys give it up for John Paul Jones!
And so, especially Tyler, he's a large dude.
Tiny guy. Very few muscles.
I don't know if you guys have seen him without a shirt on. He's a snack.
That hasn't been on social media, though.
I've noticed it a lot on yours.
What? Oddly.
Yeah.
I'm a fan.
A lot.
I'm a Tyler C. fan.
Yeah, we know. So that in itself is insightful.
I'm being silent. Okay.
That doesn't work on a podcast, by the way. Television's a very visual medium. Podcasts, not so much.
Oh, God. I love when you explain TV.
Mm. Like the cameras here today, of which there's three.
Hello.
Which, by the way, just when I have to explain television, you did ask if this fan behind me was a camera. This big white fan.
Look, that could be anything. I want to remind you that when I recently interviewed you, I showed you where your mark was on the floor.
Yes. Okay. But I'm so proud of this season. I'm so excited for this season. Kind of like, unlike any, and you know me pretty well. And I don't go overboard in bullshitting you.
All right. We are going to wrap up here. Thank you, Chris Harrison.
Lauren Zima, thank you very much. I think this was a very good professional interview. It is. Odd. It is intimidating. It is scary sitting down with someone who you know so well.
You mean you're afraid of me?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Scared to death.
Good. Glad we could finally get to know each other.
Yes.
And thank you for being here. You give me butterflies.